giving you an update on the construction at the different locations. Our Liberty Ridge location is taking shape, Christopher. It's all the siding is being put on this week. All the porticos are out, and we've had the privilege of going inside and seeing lots of sheetrock that's being formed on all the rooms, and it really is taking shape. Over the next 3 to 4 months, we'll be busy inside, going in and putting all the features in there that we're going to need to open up at the end of April. There are seniors that are signing up now for apartments, so make sure you call and get your reservation in so you have a good view. It's all about the view right now with these people that are choosing the rooms first, so make sure you contact Kim Handy at our marketing center and make a time to sit down and talk to her about what we might be able to do at that location to meet your needs. This month we decided that we would train our staff in a new program, Christopher, and I want you to talk about this that we're going to offer to our residents through our activities program. It's an exciting new program that will bring technology into the lives of our seniors and also give our activities directors a whole lot more more of an advantage in trying to find the things that they need to do to make sure our seniors are busy. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, Senior Linked is the name of the program, and what it is it's a small TV or a kiosk system that can be put pretty much anywhere, but mostly is on a rolling cart, and that cart is rolled around to any kind of common area or into a senior's room, and there is everything from the web on it to word games, puzzles,
music
videos, tons of music, everything that you can imagine from old school rock to southern gospel. It covers it all. So if you have any kind of senior that's very interested in music, we can find the needs and specialize with that music for them. There are trivia, there's reminiscing, there's all kinds of stuff that this program can do. And what's so cool about it is it has multiple things. So if you didn't want to do a big group kiosk system, you can take it down to a tablet level and you can go in the room and do one-on-one activities with these seniors.
Right, and that becomes important when our seniors go to, you know, aging in place and they're kept in their rooms more because they don't feel well or they're not able to do the things that they used to be able to do in activities. Then we can remove that, take the little tablet in and do it right there at their bedside with them so that we're not missing that population, which is so important as they age. So we are excited about Senior Linked coming into our facilities and our activities directors being able to use that, and we hope to have that going by January. So make sure that if you have any questions about that, you see one of the local activity girls and just ask them to fill you in on what's going on in the activities department with all the new things coming on. Our next item that I want to talk about is that the Leesville Road community just got through going through their annual inspection. And I want to congratulate all the girls and Laura and our upper management, Megan, John, Amy Johnson, everybody that contributed to that to make it such a success. Christopher, we received a 2-year extended license for the Leesville Road community, and that is something that we've not been able to obtain in a long time. It's tough to get through these inspections, and they go through everything in here with a fine-tooth comb, as they should. And we are proud to announce that our Leesville Road community did a fantastic job and did everything exactly the way they should have. And so our inspector has told us that we are on track and doing well. So I wanted to acknowledge Leesville Road community for their accomplishments there. Also, our Smith Mountain Lake community had an inspection as well. And Eric and Mary Beth and all the crew there did a fantastic job as well. So a big shout out to all the staff there for a job very well done. Forest is getting ready to come up in the spring, so Amy, no pressure. I know they're going to do just fine as well. We put a lot of emphasis in making sure that our standards are up to a certain level. And so we report this to you today so you understand that behind the scenes, when we are being inspected, that we take that very seriously. And we want to make sure that we stay at the highest level that we possibly can. So I wanted to report to you, 2 down, 1 to go, and they've done well. Christopher, you have to talk to us about this music video that we're involved with. Tell us a little bit about what's going on, where the folks can vote. You need to go to our Facebook page so that you can view the video. A lot of the seniors are in it from here, but tell us about how we became involved and what the prize is and all that kind of stuff.
Well, Seniors Guide is a national organization, and every year they put on a national talent show. It's called Seniors Got Talent. And
so it's not American Idol. It's
not American Idol. It's not X Factor, but Seniors Got Talent. But so we had the task of coming up with some kind of talent video for our seniors, and we chose to do a lip sync to "Don't Stop Believin'," and it was performed right here at our Leesville Road facility, and we had a lot of fun with this music video. And like she said, you can go to our Facebook page, you can go to Seniors Guide's actual website, and if you go there, we would appreciate any amount of votes you can give us.
You can vote as many times as you like, so just keep doing it over and over again. And the big thing that we want to stress is that we're in competition with many facilities along the whole entire East Coast. So it's not just Little Lynchburg or Smith Mountain Lake, it's the whole East Coast. So the more votes we get, the more that we are able to win the grand prize, which is $1,000, which can be used for our activities program to do all the wonderful things that we do with them every day. So it's really, really important that you help us out. We need your vote. And remember, you can vote as much as you want to up until the month of December. So, and they'll cut that off at the time that the votes are done.
December 31st.
So please vote, 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 vote. Go to Facebook, like us, and then make sure that you, every day, just put that in your routine. And if we win, we'll have a big party for the residents. But you're right, Christopher, I saw the faces of all the ladies and gentlemen that participated in that video, and they just had great, great fun. And we're so glad that we're able to do those little things with them and makes them feel important. And so many of them really did have a lot of things going on in that video, and so we want to make sure that they're honored for it. So vote. So that's the end of the corporate announcements. And again, we're going facility to facility and doing the filming this week. So see you at the next community. Hi, I'm Vicki Runk, and we're going to film this month's announcements. It's Thanksgiving time, and we've got lots of things going on throughout all three communities. This month, the producer, Mr. Dele, Rockson, and I decided that we would come on location and let you all have a little sneak peek in each and every community. They're all three so unique and different. And plus, I wanted you to hear the announcements straight from the activities directors themselves, give you a chance to see their face and hear a little bit about what their vision is for the program. We're going to start at the Leesville Road community, and as you can see, we're standing on Laurel Lane, and I want to introduce our new activities director, Casey. Casey, welcome to Runk Pratt Senior Living Community. We've got some exciting things coming up, and so with you, we'll go through one by one. On November the 5th at 10:30, they're having a time to where the residents all come together and they've submitted their favorite recipe. And so they're going to put all of that into a cookbook, mm-hmm. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yeah. So are we going to be able to cook some of those down the road, maybe a
yes.
favorite meal with the staff? And so that's what your plans are for that?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Great. November the 7th at 1:30, they're going to be writing letters to Santa, and they're going to be making their wish list. So if you're around on that date and would like to come over and lend Casey a hand, I'm sure that the residents would love to see you around. On November the 11th at 9:30, the Early Learning Center Daycare will be here for a Thanksgiving program. And Casey, that's such a highlight for our residents to have the little children come in and dressed up as Indians and pilgrims. And I remember when mine did that, it's just a highlight for the parents as well to be able to showcase their children. So we're looking forward to that. On November the 12th, tell us a little bit about the trip that you're going to with Smith Mountain Lake.
Well, we have gathered a bunch of our residents together, and we're going to take a trip on the bus, and we'll be arriving at the Smith Mountain Lake Runk Pratt at around 10 o'clock, and we're going to play bingo with them and socialize with them and then eat lunch there and kind of make it like a one big outing. And we're going to try to do that maybe once a quarter.
Oh,
with
great,
them.
Great. So any families that are interested in tagging along or hopping on the bus with us, if you'll see Casey, she'll make sure that you get your seat. Or if you'd like to drive behind the bus, that's fine as well. And Smith Mountain Lake facility is a great place to go and visit. It's so different than here. Lots of room, and I'm sure that you would enjoy going up there and looking around as well. On November the 13th, I've been told at 1:30 we're doing a turkey trot race, and I had to get specifics about this before we recorded today, and I've been told that that's been going to be headed up by Barb Hurt, who's not here with us today, but they're going to have little turkey trot feet around the facility, and they're going to be doing a scavenger hunt. So it's not quite the race that you would think, but it's certainly something that the residents will enjoy. On November the 13th, also at 2:30, Casey, tell us about your charades.
Well, I have found this great app on my iPad, and it's called Heads Up. And you hold the iPad on your forehead, and it you have to pick a category. Say if you wanted to pick I Love the 90s, it would come up with a theme from the 90s, and it's just like charades. And if I'm holding up, you would give me hints, and so I had to guess it. And it's a great way to use technology in the activity.
Yeah. So that would be something I would think as a family member you might want to come out and see too. Maybe even film them doing it and be able to have something to send back home or to another brother or sister and let them know that mom's having a good time with Casey with charades. On November the 14th, Casey, tell us about this group that comes in.
Jesus' Hands, they are a group of men and they play old hymns. They will play anything by request. We've always heard very, very good things from this group. They love to interact with the residents, and the residents love them as well.
Very good. So come out at 7 o'clock on November the 14th to hear Jesus' Hands. On November the 16th at 2 o'clock, Reverend Brown will do an appreciation party, and the public is invited. A little bit about that.
Reverend Brown has been coming here, he told me, a little over 25 years.
Oh my goodness.
And so we are going to kind of thank him for his time here, and we are providing refreshments and drinks and cake and ice cream. And the community is invited just as well as the residents are.
Oh, so definitely come out and show your appreciation for his dedication and loyalty all this time to this particular community. On November the 19th, the Mountain Blend ladies from Thomas Road Baptist Church, which I know so many of them, and I'm thrilled to see that they're on the schedule to come and share with our seniors here. They're going to be doing a craft, so make sure that you mark your calendars for that. On November the 20th, Casey tells me that the little Caterpillar Club, mm-hmm. which is a little daycare next door, is going to come and do a Thanksgiving program. It's special because they're our neighbors as well. And on November the 20th at 6:30, the LU students, and what department is the LU students?
The Family of Consumer Science program.
Very good. They're going to be coming in and doing a fall social. And I think that would be a great event as family, that especially since it's at 6:30, you might want to come over and participate in, because they're having food, crafts, music, and they're having a photo booth. So you could come, grab mom, take some silly pictures in the photo booth, and it's a memory that will last forever. On November the 23rd, Casey?
We're having a movie night. It's on a Saturday night, and I'm encouraging the families to come, and we're going to have popcorn and sodas, and we haven't quite picked the movie yet, but we're going to be having that in our Garden Lane living room. And so we're really looking forward to that. And we're going to hopefully do that once a month on Saturdays.
Very good. So if you, as family members, want to see this continue and be successful, make sure you come out and support Casey and her efforts to bring you and your family members together for a movie night. And finally, on November the 26th, I don't know what this is, so I'm going to let Casey tell you about it.
This is our toilet paper craft. It is really, really fun. You just take one roll of toilet paper and you roll it in orange tissue paper and you flip it up on its side and you stuff a brown paper bag in the top of it, and we cut out a jack-o'-lantern face and it turns into a pumpkin.
Oh, fun. Great fun. Well, as you can see, Casey has lots of things planned for you and your family member. Please come out, go around, and let Casey know who you are. She's new. She'd like to meet you. Let her know some specific things that maybe you'd like to see going on here, too, and she'll be glad to incorporate that into our monthly schedule. For now, until we go to our next location, I'm Vicki Runk.
And I'm Casey Burks.
See you around. Runk and Pratt Senior Living Communities would like to wish the following people here at our Leesville Road community very happy birthday wishes. Helen Christ on November the 8th. John Roberts, November the 14th. Ray Weber, November the 14th. And finally, Martha Gordon on November the 27th. From all of us, a very happy birthday. As we're going from community to community, we are now here at our forest community. Forest is a very special place in the fact that we take care of all Alzheimer's and dementia patients. All of our residents inside these doors have very special needs. And because we're filming on location today, I felt it very important that we do everything outside as not to bother them inside. So all of our interviews will be done on this beautiful porch out here in front of a forest. the porch is a very important part of this home because the residents that are inside that still have the ability to come out enjoy the outside on this very porch. Lots of times when I walk in to visit, the families are sitting over here to the side and they're communicating with their family member, and that's where a lot of special memories are created. And as this disease progresses, it's very important that we keep that family time intact. And we'll talk a little bit about that today with our administrator, Amy Johnson, who has been here for almost 13 years. So that stability that she creates in the home follows through right through these doors. Welcome to Forest, our memory care facility. We're going to go through this month's activities here at Forest, and I'd like for you to do that for us.
Okay. November the 8th, we're going to, since this is the month, November is the month of Thanksgiving, we're going to create a Thanksgiving turkey, and the leaves in the project, the feathers mm-hmm. in the project, will be all of the different things that they can remember they're thankful for. It might be family members. It might be the blessings that they feel that have been bestowed upon them, the good food, the camaraderie with each other, the music, whatever they're thankful for will populate the feathers of the turkey.
That's a great idea. And one of the things that will do is help with that reminiscent, the fact that we're exercising the mind and we're getting them to think for themselves, but we're also going to be there to help right there.
Absolutely.
On the feather or whatever we need to
right.
do.
Yeah. On November the 11th, we are honoring Veterans Day with a celebration of all of our residents, particularly our males, that sometimes don't come out as much as our females, with reminiscing about their service in the military. We'll cap that off with a celebration with patriotic music, red, white, and blue cake and ice cream, and have a great day for them to both honor their service and to bring those memories back to the forefront.
Which is important with what we do here, bringing it all back.
Absolutely. Yeah. And then we will, of course, here, we also have a handbell choir that's in rehearsal. And you would be amazed how they have the tunes that they remember. They begin playing in the rhythm of the song, not just a matter of me pointing to them and having them ring a bell. I had one little lady who said, I've never been a musician. I've never played anything. I handed her a bell. So she took it. I said, now ring the bell. She rang it. I said, now you're a musician.
Oh,
And she is one when she has a bell that rings a lot, and she just loves it.
That's great. That's great. So those are a few things that we're going to do here at Forest. Also on November the 4th, they've got yoga from 9:30 to 10. November the 5th, they have In the News, which I assume is what you're going over, the things that are in the news. And that's for some of our early onset staged residents here. And they still like to be kept informed as well. And that's from 9:30 to 10. November the 20th, he has a cooking class. So any of you that have residents at the Forest location and want to come help with that cooking class, come on out. We'd love to join you. We'd love for you to join us. Thank you, Michael, for spending time with me on the porch today. And continued best of luck with great success here. And one of the things that we want to encourage each and every one of you to do is for the month of November, we'd like for you to think of two things every day that you're thankful for. And all of a sudden, when you do that, the other things in your life seem to simply not matter quite as much. And if you'd like, I'd like for you to email me at vicki@runkandpratt.com. Let me know how that exercise worked for you this month.
Absolutely.
And see if it made a difference in your life. The Bible says to be thankful in all things. So for the month of November, we want to highlight thankfulness. And just remember, when you're having a bad day and things aren't going good, remember two things that you're thankful for. It might be as simple as your husband took the trash out without you knowing it.
How
about
that?
That's something to be thankful for. Write down those things and keep a log, and at the end of the month, see if it made a difference and let me know. Thank you so much. For the month of November, we have some very special folks inside that are celebrating birthdays. We'd like to acknowledge them today. Dora Fender has a birthday on November the 1st. And Emily Morris has a birthday on November the 8th. Happy birthday to all of you from Runk Pratt Senior Living Communities. I'm here with Janie, and we're going to go through this month's activities. Janie has worked hard to make sure that she's put together a total package to try to reach everyone with their activities needs. on November the 4th, from 12:30 to 1:30, we have Total Trivia. Janie, tell me just a little bit about what you do in that particular activity.
Well, we invite all the residents to come, and we do sports trivia, Bible trivia, music trivia, for all different walks of life, and they really enjoy the competition.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure. On November the 7th, we have bingo with the Disabled American Vets from 12:45 to 1:45. On November the 11th, we're going to be honoring our veterans from 12:30 to 1:30. Jane, tell me a little bit about what you have planned for that activity.
Well, we'll have cupcakes or cake for that, and we'll honor, we have all different branches of the service here, Marines, Army, Navy, Air Force, and we'll be honoring those veterans that are with us that we're so privileged to know.
Exactly. On November the 12th, our Leesville Road facility will be coming up and participating in a bingo competition with this group, and that gets quite heated with competition as
yes,
well. We spoke with that director yesterday, and they're excited about coming up and joining our crew, so it's a great time together. Any families that are interested in coming and helping with the bingo activity that day, it'll be a lot of fun. On November the 18th, we have a massage therapist that will be giving massages to our residents and staff. Now that sounds like something I might want to do.
Come on up, we'll take it.
So is that a local massage therapist?
Yes, it's actually from one of our volunteer ladies that came in to see the facility with one of our local women's groups. And they said, hey, I'd like to participate. I'm a massage therapist. I said, well, we have a job for you.
You plugged her right in, which is great. On November the 22nd, everybody hearing my voice that's here at our Smith Mountain Lake community, we have our big annual family Thanksgiving dinner. That's with the residents and the families, and that's from 5 to 7. And that's always very well attended.
Yes.
And for us, it's a time to get everybody together as a family, because we are a family here.
Mm-hmm.
And we get to see everybody and communicate, and it's also a way to let those residents know that it is Thanksgiving time. And just like when they lived at home, we want to make sure that we acknowledge that. So come on out and join us for that. And then finally, on November the 29th, we have the Wichard Creek Bluegrass Band. That sounds like a lot of fun, too.
Yes, yeah. They're a new group that's just started with us, and they bring all their instruments, banjos and everything, and the residents love that.
So do some toe tapping and get
yes.
on down and join her for that, too. I think it's really important that we ask the families to come out and get involved, because that just makes the volunteers want to come back more, and we so appreciate all of our volunteers. So thank you, Janie.
You're welcome.
And we'll see you around this month.
Okay, thank you.
We have some very special folks inside this facility that's going to be celebrating their birthdays for the month of November. On November the 21st, Dottie Phillips. On November the 26th, Bart Starkley. Happy birthday from Runk and Pratt Senior Living Communities to those two folks that are celebrating their birthdays with us this month at the Smith Mountain Lake community.
Well, folks, I'm here with Joey Lane, and Joey, you're actually from Omnicare Pharmacy. And Joey's got some pretty exciting news concerning some prescription and generic rate changes for some of the drugs that are commonly used. Joey, would you like to share with us and give us some more info about that?
Sure, Chris. I'd like to thank Runk and Pratt for their support of this initiative. But in October this year, we started with a new commonly used generic medication list. What this will allow is new generic drug costs. So for a 30-day single dose supply in 1 month, the cost for these medications will be $2.59. If they are to get a refill of that same medication in the same month, the refill cost will be $1. We're excited about this news because we feel it will allow responsible parties and family members a little bit more value-added services when it comes to pharmaceutical needs.
That's incredible.
So, beginning this November, these brochures will be posted at each nursing station within the Runk and Pratt facilities. Again, we're greatly honored that Runk and Pratt is allowing us to start this initiative in their buildings. If you're to have any questions about this new generic drug pricing, feel free to contact at your Omnicare pharmacy at the number below, or myself at Extended Care Associates. Thank you.
Joey, that's some great information. We appreciate you guys coming out and your partnership with us. Folks, if you would like further information, Joey's cell phone number will actually be posted below in the video, so you feel free to contact him about any more questions. But Joey, we appreciate all your time and your effort, and thank you for coming out today. Appreciate it.
Chris, we appreciate you guys, and we appreciate the residents and the responsible party's support as well. So thank you.
Thank you.
I'm here on the new wing at Smith Mountain Lake Retirement Community, to where we're filling up fast, but we want to show you a little footage of exactly what it looks like inside. So come on and we'll go on in. So we're here in the memory care garden that we just finished fencing in. And one of the things that we've been able to do is make it to where if a resident were to feel the need to go outside and they're not supervised, that they can't go anywhere. They're safe and secure, which is what a memory care unit is all about. It also gives them the ability to come out the side door here and to be able to use this entire area. So families have a spot to be able to communicate with them and spend time with them and make memories. And it also gives them a chance to get a breath of fresh air, which is so important to all of us. So wanted to be able to show too that we have a big lock out there, so no way for them to be able to get out. And that just that's able to give a family a little bit more peace of mind. And it enables us to be able to use this area so much more effectively. In closing, it's been so much fun. I've had Dele and Christopher here with me going community to community and seeing inside the lives of our residents and our staff. I hope you've enjoyed this small little video tour of what we do every day. And again, like I asked you before, think of something that you're thankful for 2 times a day. Write it down, and at the end of the month, go back and compare how that helped you be thankful. And so as we're celebrating Thanksgiving, I want to say from my heart to yours that I am so privileged and thankful to be able to serve each and every one of you every day, all of our staffs and our precious residents. It does my heart good to go in and out of these communities and get my hugs and my kisses and my well wishes. I thank you from the bottom of my heart for allowing us to serve you in the capacity that we do. So that's one big thing that I'm thankful for this month and that will never go away from my heart. Until next month, when we celebrate the birth of our Savior, I'm Vicki Runk. Thank you for joining us.